Something we have not seen in 20 years. Today on Insight and Action. Look at this. Small caps have come totally unglued over the past several weeks. We're talking about the S&P 600, which is a small cap index, versus the S&P 500, large cap index. All right, and specifically the percentage of stocks that are in an uptrend. Look at this. Typically, again, going back 20 years, they tend to move together. Well, you see what's happened recently. There are the small caps, all right? Only about 40% are still in an uptrend versus up here, you've got the large caps. We'll give it a different color. Large caps up here, about 70% are in an uptrend. That divergence is what we are talking about. We haven't seen this, as you can see, going back 20 years. So what you could do if you were a fancy hedge fund guy, you just go out and buy the IWM, which is a Russell 2000, the S&P 600, the small cap stuff, and you'd sell against that, the large cap, the S&P 500. But yeah, it's too complicated for us. So you know what? We're going to just keep it simple. And we're going to do a little screen for small cap stocks that may be worth taking a look at, specifically stocks that are down 25%, and yet stocks whose earnings are up 25%. All right, there's that discrepancy. And here's the key, no sell ratings. In other words, the analysts love them because of that earnings growth. In the S&P 600 index, there were only four that met that criteria. Checkpoint, Christopher and Banks, First Bank of Puerto Rico, and Lazy Boy. I like that one because you get the recliner, which is exactly what the small caps have been doing, reclining a little too much. This is the opportunity, all right? I have posted these tickers, as well as a few others that I actually found in one of the broader indices, the Russell 2000, at AJ Insight on Twitter. Let's talk about trying to make a little money as those small caps become completely unglued from the large caps. Maybe they get a little rally.